लिंक
Up to this, I am starting playing the emerging infection of the 24th century, and told you about its emergence in the Inner Mongolia, China. After that, the history and introduction, classification, taxonomical classification, seasonal distribution, and now I am coming to the ecology and transmission of the plague. Actually, the cycle, natural cycle of the plague is quite complex, and it inhabits both the tropical as well as the subtropical habitats. Some cases were reported also in the temperate zone as well. And plague actually having the two cycles, epizootic and endotic cycles, which we will tell you later. And epizootic cycle is characterized by here explosive spread and sudden mass mortality among the susceptible rodents. The route of plague transmission is mainly through the flea bite, through the direct contact with the tissue, secretion of the infected animals, and rarely through the inhalation of the infectious aerosol. Flea bite transmission is common during the epizootics when large number of rodents die and their flea seeks alternative source for a blood meal. Now coming to the life cycle of the rat flea. The rat flea eggs set fry with a female into the environment. After this, the eggs are hatched into the larva. Larva becomes pupa and adults. From the pupa, adults are formed. This adults directly on the human as well as the rodents like cats, rats, dogs, and other type of rodents. And after coming in contact with such rodents, we will get the infection of plague. Now coming to the human transmission, it occurs in the epizootic and endotic cycle. Epizootic cycle is when the transmission is occur in the non-human primates from the rat flea, and endotic is the rat is infected from the bite of the rat flea, and then the human is transmitted. There is direct contact which causes the bubonic plague, and if caused by the aerosol, then it causes the pneumonic plague. Now coming to its vector, which is the most common, is the Xenophila cheops, also known as the Oriental rat flea. It is the parasites of rodents primarily of the genus Rattus, and the primary vector for the both bubonic plague and the murine typhus. Can live in the warm-blooded animal, and the scientific classification is this belongs to the kingdom Animalia, phylum Orthopoda, class is Insecta, order is Cyponectera, family is Culicidae, and genus Xenophila, and species is Xenophila cheops. This is the slide which shows about the animal reservoirs and the primary vector for this disease. There are several animal reservoirs like Indian gerbil rat, bandicoot rat, Indian field mouse, Spanish field mouse, Indian bus rat, palm squirrels are there. And the primary vectors are most common is the Xenophila cheops, and the your will filia, which is the Genopsila astia nasocelus punjabensis. This is a history part. In the above, it is the three main pandemic which occurred before, and in 1894, Alexander Yersin, which find the plague bacterium in samples from the human and rat during the Hong Kong epidemic. 1895, wild rodents confirmed as a host of plagues. And in 1896, Hapkin, which develops a partially effective heat kill vaccine, used it during an outbreak in Bombay. And this is 97, Yersin proposes link between rats, plagues, you see. And this is the history of the last causing three major pandemic over the past 1500 years. First pandemic occurred in Byzantine Empire during the 6th century, which killed an estimated of 40 million persons in Mediterranean Basin. And in 14th century, in 1346, second pandemic began in Central Asia and spread west along caravan routes to reach the Crimean seaport of Kaffa. Now it is Theodosia in the Ukraine. And the third pandemic and modern pandemic began in China, which is Yunnan province in 1850s. Now coming to the epidemiology part, plague is epidemic in the area of mainly Africa, Asia and America, including the Western United States. Before 2007, between 1,000 to 6,000 cases, which were reported annually to WHO from the 25 major countries. And 80% cases is lonely reported from the Africa, 15% from the Asia, and remaining from the America. From the 2010 to 2018, 500 cases were about reported annually to WHO, and this time is most prevalent in the rural areas of Madagascar, Uganda, Democratic Republic of Congo. And in 2007, the recent outbreak occurred in Madagascar, capital of Madagascar, which was mainly of pneumonic plague. This is the Madagascar outbreak report here. This is the report I had published at 22nd October 2017. In this outbreak, total cases notified at 1,297, of which 846 were the cases of pneumonic plague, and 102 deaths were reported, and 39 out of 114 districts in Madagascar have been affected, with the highest number of cases detected in the capital. And only 270 cases is bubonic. Actually, the most common type of plague occur is the bubonic plague, but in this outbreak, the cases of pulmonary plague is so high than the bubonic plague. Mm-hmm. And 270 bubonic plague, 1 septicemic plague, and 180 is non-specified cases are reported. This is the world map showing the plague distribution. Here in the brown color is the outbreak in 2020, which is Inner Mongolia of China country. And outbreak in the 21st century occur in the Peru region. This is the Peru, China, Congo, and India. And the where plague is just an animal disease is the Western USA part, Bolivia region, Brazil region, and Libya, Saudi Arabia, and many more countries are affected as it's just as an animal disease. Now coming to the data which is collected. And this is from 2013 to 2018 of various countries. In Democratic Republic of Congo, in 2013, 55 cases, 5 were and 5 deaths are reported. 2015, and Recently, in 2013, Democratic Republic of Congo has 133 cases reported, Madagascar 104 cases reported, and in America region, Bolivia 1 cases, Peru 1 cases, and United States of America 1 cases reported. In Asia region, China, Russian Federation, Kazakhstan, Mongolia reported no cases. But in 2020, on 7 July, Mongolia reported 2 cases. That's why there is a chances of a future pandemic of plague. And this Indian epidemiology from 1963, plague were distributed throughout India, and 197 cases were reported, among these 22 deaths. In 64, peninsular region of India is affected, which is 106 cases and 13 deaths. 1965, 1 cases. 66, 46 cases were reported, where in which two deaths were reported. And from 67 to 93, no cases and death were reported. In 1994, Maharashtra and Gujarat district having an outbreak and reported 876 cases. Among these, 54 deaths were reported. And 2002, Simla has reported 16 cases. Among these, 4 deaths were reported. And 2004, Uttarkashi district of Uttarakhand reported 8 cases. Among these, 3 deaths were reported. And from 2005 to 2009, no cases were reported till now. And now coming to the pathogenesis. The disease started with the bite of the flea. Flea become infected when feeding on the bacteremic host. After feeding, its inoculated bacteria likely phagocytized and killed by the polymorphonuclear lymphocytes. Few will survive and only taken up by the mononuclear cells, and it carried via the lymphatics to regional lymph nodes. It grows at the 37 degrees Celsius. Bacteria begin expressing the F1 envelopment antigen, which is enhancing their ability to resist subsequent phagocytosis and causing the disease. Within lymph node, it stimulates an intense inflammatory response, which is clinically detected as the bubo. And fully developed bubo reveals the invasion of polymorphonuclear lymphocytes, hemorrhagic necrosis with destruction of normal architecture and dense concentration of extracellular vesicles. In the absence of the therapy, it leads to the other conditions like disseminated intravascular coagulation, secondary pneumonia, acute renal failure, and irreversible shock. Blockage of the vessel can also occur in the cooler acral sacs, which leads to the gangrene. And by the rapid destructive of pro-inflammatory phase, there is the cause of the pneumonic wave, which results in the death of the patient. Now coming to the transmission of how the bubonic plague is transmitted. Bubonic plague is transmitted by the infected, mainly by the flea bite. The immune evasion of the plague is done by the several mechanisms, by type 3 secretory system mediated neutralization of immune cells. The second one is the absence of detectable pathogen associated molecular patterns, and the third one is the modulation of host innate immune cells interaction. After this, the mainly in the plague, neutrophils are the very early line of innate defense and inflammation. When the Yersinia pestis eliminates from the neutrophil killing, and survive and replicate when phagocytized by the macrophages. When macrophages phagocytize infected neutrophil in a cleaning process, it is known as the epherocytosis. And within macrophage, it can survive and can survive in autophagosome. After that, Yersinia pestis migrate via the lymph nodes and goes to the subcapsular sinus, and it causes the infected draining lymph node, which is called as the bubo. And it can also go to the bloodstream and causing the septicemia, which causes leading to the multi-organ failure and clinical signs and symptoms, and at last, if the, in the absence of the proper treatment, death can be occur. This is the transmission of the pneumonic plague. Pneumonic plague actually of two types, which I discuss later. Actually, pneumonic plague is the primary pneumonic plague, which is directly from the inhalation of droplet aerosol formation. And there is the secondary pneumonic plague, which occurs through the which comes from the bubonic plague. Actually, bubonic plague and it causes the lung failure, septicemia, cytokine storm, and at last the person may death occur. This is the virulence factor taken from the Mendel. The most virulent factor is the plasmin PCT1, which is the plasminogen activator. PCT1 plasmin, which has the yolk, which is the Yersinia outer membrane protein, and the V antigen. The third one is the PMT1 and PFRA plasmid, and the last one is the chromosomal mediated, which is the hemine Storer system, Yersinia vectoring system, lipopolysaccharide, and PS6 fimbria antigens, which having the different activities to cause the disease of plagues. This is also the virulence factor, which is one is the plasmid of 70 kilobase called the low calcium response plasmid, PYB or PCD1. Here, type 3 secretory system, which causes the insertion of Yersinia outer membrane protein through a needle-like injectiosome into neutrophils, macrophage, and dendritic cell, V antigens, and Yersinia outer membrane proteins. The other one is the plasmid of 100 kilobase called PFRA and PMT1. In this, fraction 1 capsular antigen, which is known as F1 antigen, and murine toxins are there, which causes the inhibition of phagocytosis, and the murine toxin causes the survival of bacteria and the flea bite. The other one is a plasmid of 9.5 kilobase called the PPST of PPCP1, which is the plasminogen activator, and its activity is the activation of host plasminogen to plasmin for lysis of clots, cleavage of extracellular matrix, promotion of the bacterial spread, and its multiplication in the lungs. The next one is the chromosomal pigmentation locus PGM, which have two things: hemine storage and Yersinia vectoring. Hemine storage causes formation of obstructive biofilm in the flea gut, and the Yersinia vectoring is a siderophore for the iron transport. The other one is the chromosome locus under regulation of ROBA, which is PS6 antigen. Its main function is inhibition of phagocytosis, and the chromosomal locus for AIL protein, which is outer membrane, causes the resistance to complement-mediated killing of the Yersinia species. The last one is the chromosomal locus for the cell wall synthesis. Here, the liposaccharide present in the Yersinia pestis is the rough type due to lack of the O antigen, but in the genus Yersinia enterocolitica and Yersinia pseudotuberculosis, liposaccharide is the smooth type. Here, the rough one liposaccharide causes the initiation of inflammatory response, which leads to the septic shock, and also for the anti-inflammatory non-stimulation of toll-like receptor 4. Now, I am coming to the clinical manifestations of plague. The clinical manifestation mainly depends on the root of scale. Actually, Plague is divided into three types. Is primary bubonic plague, which is the most common form, causing 80 to 85% of the plague cases. Then septicemic plague, 15% cases, and the pneumonic plague, which occur in 1 to 3% of cases. Incubation period of plague is usually 2 to 7 days, but it can be as short as 1 day for the patient with pneumonic plague also. Now coming to bubonic plague. Bubonic plague is mainly caused from the cutaneous exposure, which is characterized by its sudden onset of high fever, chills, weakness, and headache. It is the regional lymph node swelling and mainly becomes apparent in the area of groin, axilla, and neck within its first day of infection. The size of the bubble vary from the 1 to 10 cm and it's elevated from the upper line skin. Bubble can be warm and erythematous, and the palpation can cause extreme tenderness. It can be distinguished from the other form of lymphadenitis by its sudden onset, intensity of inflammation in bubo, and usual absence of obvious skin lesions or associated ascending lymphangitis. Examination distal to the bubo reveals a small papule or scab, which demarcates the site of the flea bite. And in this bubonic plague, rarely ulcer or SCR may develop. Differential diagnosis for bubonic plague is scratch disease, staphylococcal or streptococcal lymphadenitis, tularemia, filarial lymphadenitis, centroid and other sexually transmitted disease also, and the last one is the strangulated hernia. Now coming to the septicemic plague, which is associated in 15% of cases, characterized by the sudden onset of high fever without associated bubo or other obvious localizing sign. It is the rapidly progressive and causes overwhelming sepsis and organ failure within few days. Here, septicemic plague also causes the gastrointestinal symptoms of nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, as well as the abdominal pain. And due to the delay in the diagnosis and treatment, the fatality rate of the septicemic plague is quite high, which is approximately 28% of cases, and it is 3 times higher than the fatality rate for the bubonic plague. Now coming to the pneumonic plague, which occurs in the 1 to 3% of the cases. In pneumonic plague, actually in two forms, secondary and primary form. It is very much fatal and potentially contagious to the close contact. Secondary pneumonic plague is more common form because it occurs after the bubonic plague, and the cases of bubonic plague is quite high, which occur in 80 to 85% cases. So the secondary pneumonic plague cases is quite high than the primary pneumonic plague. It arises through the hemagglutinous spread of bacteria from a bubo or other sources. Approximately 10% of all plague patients develop secondary pneumonic plague due to the result of the delayed treatment of the bubonic infection. It begins as an interstitial process with cup productive of scanty tenacious sputum, which beginning from 5 to 6 days after the onset of illness. Chest radiography shows diffuse alveolar infiltrates, which always bilateral and associated with the pleural effusion also. If the pneumonic plague is untreated, sputum becomes more copious and become eventually bloody, and death with occur within 3 to 4 days. Now coming to the primary pneumonic plague. Primary pneumonic plague is occur due to the result from the direct inhalation of the bacteria into the lungs by the aerosol generation. And it is a quite fulminant condition can occur through the contact with another patient with pneumonic plague and exposure to the animals, especially cats, with respiratory or pharyngeal plague. Laboratory exposure can also lead to the primary pneumonic plague due to aerosol generation, and there is the intentional aerosol release for the purpose of bioterrorism, which can cause also the primary pneumonic plague. The symptoms of primary pneumonic plague begins within 1 to 4 days after exposure, and the clinical symptoms develop a sudden onset of fever, chills, headache, malaise, rapidly advancing tachypnea, dyspnea, hypoxia, chest pain, cough, hemoptysis, and general signs of endotoxemia. The other syndromes which is associated, with the plague disease is plague meningitis, which is the rare complication, and the symptoms include is fever, headache, sensory neural changes, and meningismus. Examinations of CSF reveals leucocytosis with predominance of polymorphonuclear lymphocytes. And the another rare presentation is pharyngeal plates, which resembles the acute tonsillitis. Anterior cervical lymph nodes are inflamed, and sometimes osteomyelitis involving the both skull and long bones are there. Now coming to the diagnosis part, diagnosis can be divided into clinical diagnosis, radiological diagnosis, and laboratory part. The general test done for this disease is peripheral WBC count, which generally ranges from the 10,000 to 25,000 cells per mm cube, with predominance of immature neutrophils, and there occur leukemia reactions with count as high as 50,000 or greater can occur. Platelet count are normal or low in the early stage, and for plague, single blood culture positive comes in 25 to 27% of cases. The other conditions occurred associated with plague are disseminated intravascular coagulation, thrombocytopenia, elevated results of liver function test, and renal functions are common in the advanced stages of the illness. When the plague is suspected, there is the collection of diagnostic specimens, and chest radiograph is done to rule out the pneumonia. Diagnostic specimen for plague is mainly blood, Dubois aspirates, sputum, tracheobronchial vases, tracheobronchial swabs, pharyngeal mucosa, and cerebrospinal fluid. Depending on the type of plague, specimens are collected. For bubonic type of plague, pus or fluid aspirate from the bubble are collected. Pneumonic plague, respiratory specimens are collected, and as well as the blood samples are collected. For septicemic plague, blood and splenic aspirates are the usual sample. The Dubois aspirate, how it is collected? Actually, it is obtained by the inserting 20 gauze needle on a 10 ml syringe and containing 2 ml of sterile saline solution into the Dubois, and then withdrawing the plunger several times until the saline solution becomes the blood paste. Then all the patient specimen should be handled in the biosafety level 2 facility. Here, the subculture should be done in class 2 biosafety cabinets, and due to the risk of generation of aerosol, liquid culture manipulations should be performed under the biosafety level 3 conditions. For transportation, Kelly-Blair medium as well as the Schwartz medium is used, and the specimen should be sent to the laboratory immediately. If delay in transit of more than 2 hours is expected, then the transport of the specimen at 2 to 8 degrees Celsius for in the transportation media. Serum may be stored at 2 to 8 degrees Celsius for up to 14 days. And if the sera is stored for the more than 14 days, it should be frozen. This is the diagram which shows the all the tests associated with the detection of the Yersinia pestis. This is the rapid detection test, immunochromatographic test, where the detection of the F1 antigen within 15 minutes. This is the real-time PCR. The real-time PCR which detect the gene PLA and CAF1, and the result come in 2 to 5 hours. The other methods are the culture method, staining methods, biochemical methods, mass spectrography method. I am coming to the later slides. This is the direct microscopy. Direct microscopy done on the Gram stain as well as the Wesson stain or methylene blue stain. On Gram stain, it shows the presence of the pus cells and Gram negative over Foucault baseline. This rounded end surrounded by the capsule. On Wesson and methylene blue stain, it shows the typical bipolar or septic pin appearance, which is seen in the below picture. This is the septic pin appearance. Here both the ends are having taken the stain, but the center one is empty due to the presence of vacuole here. Culture. This bacteria is both aerobic and facultative anaerobic, and the optimal temperature for growth is 25 to 27 degrees Celsius. But capsule may develop at 37 degrees Celsius. This is the non-fastidious bacteria. On the blood agar, it shows non-hemolytic colony and gray-white to slightly yellow, opaque, raised, irregular, fried egg morphology is seen. On McConkie agar, it shows lactose non-fermenting colorless colony and nutrient broth gives granular turbidity with surface pellicles, which is formed later. On nutrient block with oil or ghee floated on the top, stalactite growth hanging down from the under surface of oil is seen. And there is a selective media which is used actually on selective media seen agar, which contain cefsulodium, aggression, and novovirusin, which helps in the inhibition of the other growth of the other enterobacteriaceae group, and it is mainly the selective medium for the Yersinia enterocolitica. Yersinia enterocolitica growth occur in the seen agar, but there is no growth of Yersinia pestis, and the growth is slower compared with the blood agar. Culture is, if I am going to make the smear from the culture, it reveals pleomorphism. It may be coquia, corcobacillary, bacillary, filamentous, and maybe the giant form. It is non-motile both at the 25 and 37 degrees Celsius. But the other is pathogenic Yersinia species like Enterocolitica and pseudotuberculosis are motile species. The biochemical test associated with this is glucose, mannitol, maltose fermented with production of acid, but no gas is formed. It is both sucrose and lactose non-fermented, catalase positive, oxidase negative, indole negative, citrate utilization test is negative, urease negative, MR positive, and VP test is negative. On the basis of biochemical reaction, mainly on the basis of nitrate reaction and glycerol fermentation, Yersinia pestis divided into mainly three biotypes, which causes the three different pandemic at the different time. The first biotype is the Medievalis, which is nitrate reduction negative but glycerol fermentation positive, and it causes the first pandemic in 541 AD. The second biotype is Antiqua, which is the nitrate reduction positive and glycerol fermentation positive, and it causes the second pandemic, which is also known as the Black Death, occurred in Europe in the year 1347 to 52. And the third biotype is the Orientalis, which is nitrate reduction positive and glycerol fermentation negative, and it causes third pandemic, in which occurred in Hong Kong, China, and as well as our country India from 1894 to 1918. The other diagnostic modality is detection of the F1 antigen. It is detected from the bubo aspirate or sputum by direct immunofluorescence test, ELISA, or rapid test like immunochromatographic test by using monoclonal antibody. And the other test is the detection of antibody against the F1 antigen. It is done by the ELISA, passive agglutination test, complement fixation test, and this is the useful epidemiological marker because the antibodies to the F1 antigen remain positive for the several years. And the last molecular methods are there, which is done by the real-time PCR at level, which targets the gene coding F1 antigen, plasticine gene, and plasminogen activator gene. And this time automated system are also there, like MALDI and VITEX system, which is used for the detection of Yersinia pestis also. Now coming to the preventive measures. Preventive measures divided into four subgroups, which first is the infection control, chemoprophylaxis, vaccination, environmental control. Infection control is done in those with cough or other signs of pneumonia, placed in isolation and managed under respiratory droplet precautions for at least 48 hours after initiation of antibiotic therapy or until sputum culture becomes negative. To prevent the person-to-person transmission, suspected pneumonic plague patient is managed in isolation under respiratory droplet precaution, strict isolation under negative pressure, and filtering exhaust not necessary because infection dispersal by fine aerosol or dried droplet nuclei does not occur. The second one is the respiratory droplet precaution. It is done by the use of mask, gown, gloves, and protective eyewear when providing direct patient care. Culture usually negative after 24 hours of treatment, and the infective fluids should be handled with gloves and with care to avoid the formation of aerosol. The routine clinical specimen managed in the laboratory under biosafety level 2 precautions, but the culture should be performed in a negative pressure hood using biosafety level 3 procedures. Now coming to the chemoprophylaxis, it is given to the person having an infective exposure within previous 7 days, such as family members, care providers, and other with close and direct contact with patient with pneumonic plague or laboratory worker exposed to accident. Chemoprophylaxis, I am taking in later slide. Vaccination. There are two types of plague vaccination. Which one is the killed whole cell vaccine and the other is live attenuated vaccine. Killed whole cell vaccine is not effective against the respiratory exposures and no usefulness in combating epidemic disease in a setting of modern sanitation and prophylactic antibiotics. It is given subcutaneously 2 doses 4 weeks apart and the booster given after the 6th month. Whole killed vaccine is contraindicated in infants less than 6 months of age and not protective against the pneumonic plague. Now the series of candidate vaccines have been developed, which uses recombinant capsular subunit protein F1 and low calcium response V antigen, either as a mixture of two antigens or as a fusion of the two antigens. Recent approaches toward vaccine immunization includes development of DNA vaccines by using different vectors, expression of protective antigens in live bacterial, viral and plant carrier, passive immunization with aerosolized monoclonal antibodies, and the vaccines based on attenuated Yersinia pseudotuberculosis. Now I am coming to the case definition taken from the Harrison. Suspected cases. Suspected, presumptive, and confirmed cases. Suspected cases are having the compatible clinical presentation and having consistent epidemiological features such as exposure to infected animal or humans, or evidence of clear bite or residence in or travel to a known endemic focus within the previous 10 days. Presumptive cases meeting the definition of suspected cases plus more than two of the following test positive: microscopy, F1 antigen detected, anti-F1 serology, or PCR detection of Yersinia pestis. Known endemic focus causes more than equal to one of the following test positive, that is microscopic evidence, anti-F1 serology, or F1 antigen detection. Confirmed cases meets the definition of the suspected cases plus identification of an isolate from a clinical sample, such as colony morphology, and the two of the following four test positive: phage lysis, F1 antigen detection, PCR, and biochemical profiles. Or there is the four-fold rise in the anti-F1 titer in paired serum sample or in endemic area when no other confirmative test can be performed. A positive rapid diagnostic test with immunochromatography to detect F1 antigen can be positive. Now coming to the prophylaxis. The main drugs used for the chemoprophylaxis is doxycycline, tetracycline, levofloxacin, and ciprofloxacin. And this is the usual dosage of these drugs. Doxycycline in adults, daily dosage of 200 mg, and in children more than equal to 8 years, which weight is more than equal to 45 kg, adult dose, and which weight is less than equal to 45 kg, 2.2 mg per kg, 2 times a day is given. A maximum dose cannot stand after 200 mg. Tetracycline adult dose is 1 to 2 gram. Child more than equal to 8 years, 25 to 50 mg per kg. Levofloxacin adult and child more than 50 kg, daily dose of 500 mg. And child less than 50 kg and more than 6 months of age, 16 mg per kg, and maximum dose is 250 mg dose. Ciprofloxacin adult dose is 1 gram daily dose, and child dose is 40 mg per kg.
Dr. Sarov, please hurry up, we have a faculty meeting at 12.
Treatment part consists of the gentamicin, streptomycin, levofloxacin, ciprofloxacin, mosifloxacin, doxycycline, tetracycline, and chloramphenicol. And these are the doses of each drug. And now at the last, I am coming to the conclusion. Plague is the zoonotic disease caused by the vector Rhaplia genoxyla chiopsis. Mode of transmission by the various ways, like a bite of an infected rat flea, direct contact with tissue of infected animals, droplet inhalation, and bite of an infected human flea, which is pulous irritants. And mainly three types: bubonic, septicemic, and pneumonic plague. And at last, the prevention of the disease is the most important part, which is done by the infection control by using antibiotics, chemoprophylaxis, vaccination, biological control, including rat proving dwellings, removing food and harvest for rodents, using repellents, and by applying insecticides on their pets. This is the other species, like other than the Yersinia pestis, Yersinia and Troglodytica. This is the motile species at the temperature of 22 to 29 degrees Celsius, but not motile at normal human body temperature. Infection, the infection caused by this is called the arseniosis. The portal of entry is gastrointestinal tract, and the organism acquired by the contaminated water, meat or milk. Usually tend to mild self-limited enterocolitis or terminal ileitis and adenitis. Symptoms include watery or bloody diarrhea and fever resembling acute appendicitis or salmonellosis or shigellosis. This is the disease arseniosis. It is an infection caused mainly by the Yersinia enterocolitica, mostly occur in the young children. Infection through the consumption of undercooked, mixed, unpasteurized milk, water contaminated with bacteria. Common symptoms: fever, abdominal pain, diarrhea. Diarrhea is often bloody, and in older children and adults, starch-sided abdominal pain occurs with mimics with the acute appendicitis. Treatment include the doxycycline as a drug of choice, and aminoglycoside can also prefer. Alternative therapies should be ciprofloxacin, fluoroquinolones, as well as cotrimoxazole. Thank you.
Okay. Dr. Saurabh, we will have question now. First question coming from Dr. Gagandeep sir. Sir wants to highlight on Indian outbreaks. Go to your Indian outbreak slide and please highlight. Please discuss. What are the recent Indian outbreaks?
Indian outbreaks mainly occur in the after the third pandemic. In 1896 to 1918, Hong Kong pandemic entered in India. And after that, from 1918 to 1967, plague gradually declined. And occasional cases continued to be reported from the endemic foci of India, like...
What is the endemic foci for India?
Endemic foci is the Maharashtra, Gujarat, and...
Which one is the recent one?
Recent one is the 2004 Uttarkashi, Uttarakhand.
How many cases are reported?
Ma'am,
800 something.
Ma'am, Uttarkashi, 8 cases are reported and 3 among 3 deaths were occurred. And
it would be better if you show it in your slide. Okay. And the second question coming from Dr. Gagandeep sir, he wants to emphasize on biosafety consideration. What are the biosafety levels?
Biosafety levels are actually divided into the 4 types. Biosafety level 1, where the organisms...
Yersinia pestis in which biosafety level you will handle?
Yersinia pestis come under the biosafety level 3 organisms. And the BSL 1 organisms is... non-pathogenic strain of E. coli.
Okay. Yersinia comes under BSL-3. Okay. The third question coming from Dr. Asis, interesting question. Which other bacteria can be grown in CIN medium? Cinnagar. Yeah. One you have mentioned in Yersinia enterocolitica, which shows a red collar colonies. Which other bacteria grows in this medium? Do you remember? Oh, yeah, you have to search the answer and please mention in your PPT. Then Dr. Rama ma'am has asked a very interesting question. Which secretion system is seen in Yersinia?
Type 3 secretion system is seen in Yersinia.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Which other organism has this? Apart from Yersinia, which other organism?
Ma'am, other organism is Salmonella, Shigella.
Salmonella, with Salmonella, is it typhi or
non-typhi? I'm not sure about that.
Please look after the answer and please reply in the mail. Dr. Rama again has a very interesting question. A medieval years type of nitrate negative was isolate available? Is the isolate available?
Medieval years, yes.
Which phase is used for phase lysis test?
Duophagy.
Which phase? You have to. There is a number. Okay. Okay. Himachal outbreak, yes. Himachal, there was a. Yes. That you have to.
2002 Himachal outbreak. Yes. Simla outbreak.
Yes. That Dr. Gagandeep has mentioned. I think that's all. Okay. I think we have taken all the questions. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.